don't have to worry about Lizzie. She's harmless.
Bit free with the poison in her younger days, though.
Did you mean she actually poisoned people?
Arsenic in the cooking pot.
And that woman's bringing us our food, my God.
If you don't pull your head in, I'll knock it off.
No, piss off.
Come on, birds, let's keep them moving.
Rat man roll!
And tonight, on my show, we have exclusive interviews with former cast members of the television show Christmas. Even though it finished many years ago, it still has a huge loyal following, with many fans in Australia and England coming yearly together to have a fan club meeting. Next year will be the 30th, so please get your bookings in. That's Delia with the rock lobster calling. I'll call you back in the next time. Yay! Speaking of your son, not so long ago, maybe a couple of years ago, Desiree's son was on the news here for rescuing some drowning people.
I will be here in 2009. Please join us.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Thank you.
And we both got shiver sheep.
Yay!
And I just want to say a very special thank you. And a huge kiss and a hug to Barry and Scott, who do a fantastic job on the site. I checked out the site the other day, and you guys really are amazing.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And please, will you come to our 2009 30th anniversary Christmas? I'll fill you up on one.
Okay. Bye.
Miss Ferguson,
you know that all women here call you love freak.
I don't think either of these two make any sense at all. And I love them both.
I thought we were making
sense. Love and all things shining to you.
I thought we were being very professional.
Sadly, I beg to differ.
Oh, Barry.
No.
Oh,
God.
Barry? You're not Barry.
I was thinking of Scott.
Please come to the 2009 30th anniversary.
I'm still here.
Where were you? See, just a little bit. You saw that. Did you push me out?
You're not
you
happy.
Move out of here immediately or I get the fire hose.
Because you're my greatest.
And what are you doing, Miss Ferguson? Charge me.
You're going to buy someone.
I don't think I have ever come across anyone as cold-blooded as you are, Mackenzie.